First question which has come out is, we have seen a lot of diagrams over there, a lot of models which we have seen. Are they really necessary to do it? Why they are there for so many diagrams creation for this type of work? Can you just throw some light on that?
Okay. Application rationalization is not a localized problem. It is an enterprise-wide problem. And enterprise architecture approach is very much applicable for the situation. So when you are thinking in those terms, there are multiple stakeholders across the enterprise, and their concerns need to be addressed. And the business stakeholders look at things differently to the executive stakeholders, and the technology stakeholders understand things differently to the business stakeholders. So that means the way they want to look at solution options, the way they want to look at various diagrams or spreadsheets or whatever, they're all different. So that means you have to create enough and adequate models and diagram to satisfy their concerns. So the whole point of enterprise architecture is to satisfy major key stakeholders' concerns. Otherwise, it will never get signed off. So you may satisfy, suppose it was IT-driven, and you satisfy the IT stakeholders' concerns, that means you may not be satisfying the business stakeholders' concerns. So you can produce a limited number of artifacts and satisfy the IT concerns. That will still not get approval from the business, and it will get stuck. So it's a complex work. So you have to create multiple diagrams to satisfy different stakeholders. But the interesting point is, we can create all these diagrams to satisfy different stakeholders very, very quickly because of the enterprise anatomy approach. If it was a manual process, PowerPoint, Visio, whatever, it would take enormous amount of time to do that. So with us, it's not a limitation at all to create many, many multiple artifacts. It's very quick. It's a click of a button.